Welcome to Dorchester Art Housing Collaborative.
Thank you, I'm so excited to be here.
After being shuttered for 7 years, a CHA complex in Chicago's Greater Grand Crossing neighborhood is reopening its doors to tenants.
So please tour, enjoy open doors. Take your time.
But this is not your typical public housing complex. Instead, the new Dorchester Art and Housing Collaborative will contain a novel mixture of artists, CHA residents, and mixed-income tenants. A total of 5 artists will live here, working on projects with other tenants and others in the community.
I know there are other artist communities, and artists have, you know, having one complex devoted to artists, but I actually think having a certain percentage of artists working within, this just feels right.
Noted artist and urban planner Theaster Gates came up with the idea. His Rebuild Foundation worked with the CHA, Brinshore Development, and the architectural firm Landenbaum Baker on the $11 million renovation project in the once working-class Grand Crossing community, where 25% of its households now live below poverty level.
It seems too easy to just tear down buildings and erase the memory of what was here. So to take a building like this and transform what it maybe was into what it can be, and have the neighbors participate and see the fact that there is something valuable in this neighborhood. And of course, they're a huge value in the neighborhood, but their buildings are also valuable. And we're just such a throwaway society. So to save that is important.
Dorchester Projects, it's essentially a model that suggests that any old two flat could be both a place where people live and do things that apartments do, but they can also be places where cultural activity happens among friends and neighbors.
Gates has already renovated 3 other abandoned buildings in the Grand Crossing community. Those buildings, called the Dorchester Projects, are now combination living quarters for Gates and others, in addition to being repositories for donated art and artifacts from the University of Chicago and other institutions. But the Dorchester Art and Housing Collaborative takes Gates' concept of embedding artists in his community to an entirely different level.
Very much a part of Rebuild's mission is artistic practice. We want to support artists. We also believe, again, in community engagement and individual empowerment. So how can art serve those 3 factors? We don't want individuals here who just want to work in isolation.
You can live somewhere and give your gifts and your talents.
The artists living in the complex are already coming up with ideas on how to work with their neighbors.
I'm looking forward to working with the Rebuild Foundation and documenting the stories out of this community to let the world know that, you know, there is change happening in the inner cities. You know, I know the news and what you hear is a lot of bad going on, but there's still a lot of good going on.
This isn't a place where you should not know what's going on inside. We want people to not only look inside, but to come inside.
The complex started accepting residents in October, and its 32 units are now almost completely occupied. But the official ribbon cutting for the complex will take place on November 19th, when a new art center will open on the grounds, both for residents and others in the community.
The art center will be a dance studio. The heart of the work that we do, the work of it being a public space, will take place in the art center. It's a passion project, not only for me personally, but also for Rebuild. But it's a passion project that has strategy.